guys? It's Caitlin from Paradise Hotel. So this video is going to be me answering all the questions that you guys have, clarifying things, and just keeping it real. I want this video to be super authentic. You know, I'm not here to edit and make a whole pretty video. It's just me simply answering questions and getting this done. I'm excited because you guys don't know the full story or just things that people need to know that is bullshit. So one of the biggest things that people were confused about and want to know more about is me and Rosanna's relationship on the show. Basically, I walked in and, you know, as a new girl, I was like, I need to figure out who's the strongest girl here. I need to figure out who she is and be friends with her because I'm making it to the end. So I realized it was Rosanna. I went up to Rosanna and I was like, you know, this was like a random night. I'm like, hey, look, I know you don't know me. I'm new. You may or may not believe me, but I want you to know that I'm very strong, like yourself. So it's either A, we can do this together. We can do this whole competition together. Me and you, strong personalities. Or if you want to go against me, I want you to know this will be war. Me and you going against each other is dangerous. So which one do you pick? She said, you know what, Caitlin, I really like you. I want to do this with you. Let's do it. Okay, Rosanna. I was so excited. I finally had a friend. I was like, yo, me and the strongest girl are gonna kill it. Next day, we all find out there's like a ceremony, and all I'm hearing throughout the whole entire day is that Rosanna's trying to get me out. Rosanna's telling Carlos that she thinks he's the hottest guy and that she wants to be with him. Like, she's never ever said that to Carlos before. So how is it that the day of the ceremony, you want to tell Carlos now that you find him attractive, number one? Number two, I heard that she was telling everybody that I need to go because I'm not trusted. So the whole day, everybody was out to get me. Everybody wanted me out. And I told Carlos, because Carlos had my back, which I was shocked about. I said, Carlos, if you really want me to stay, then let's do this. And this is what you guys didn't see. Me and Carlos plotted this whole thing. Let's make Rosanna think that you want to be with her and you're going to pick her over me and have her stand behind you tonight. This way we can send her home. Because the first thing I wanted, the second I found out she was going against me, like I told her, if you don't want to do this with me, we're going to war. So that whole day I was like, Carlos, I'm going to play dumb. I'm going to act like I don't know what Rosanna's doing. And we're going to send that girl home. So the whole day, Carlos pretended like he was in on the plan. He was going to send me home. Everybody thought I was going to go home. Tatum was in on it. Everybody knew Caitlin was going home. But nobody knew that me and Carlos had each other's back. So Carlos played it off perfect. Shout out to Carlos with the good acting skills. And Rosanna fell for it. She stood behind Carlos that night. And that's why I said to her at the ceremony, I told you, if you wanted to go against me, you were asking for war. Now you're going home. Have a safe flight. A couple people can argue that I'm not the reason that Rosanna went home. I mean, Tyler wanted Shaylee over Rosanna. But something that you guys don't know or didn't see was Shaylee actually wanted to go home herself. She was going to check herself out. She wanted to stand behind Carlos with me. This way Carlos can just send her home. She did not want to be on Paradise Hotel. And I said to her, I said, number one, Shaylee, stop. Because Tyler really likes you. I see it. Tyler wants to be with you. Stay with him, Shaylee. Do this. We were roommates. Me and Shaylee actually were like super close, which is another thing people didn't see. Me and Shaylee had a very strong friendship, and I was there for her every step of the way of making her and Tyler more successful as a relationship. So I said to her, I'm like, look, if you stay, two things can happen. Number one, if you show Tyler that you actually really do care about him and you want to be with him, tell him, because he will send Rosanna home. I know he will. Number two, Shaylee, do this for me. You're my only hope. If, let's just say something goes wrong and, you know, Tyler tells Rosanna last minute he wants to be with her, she's not going to go home. And I need this girl home. I want her off the show. So please, Shaylee, even if you don't want to be with Tyler, stand behind him and let's make sure she goes home. Do it for me. So Shaylee's decision was, of course, primarily based on the fact that she loves Tyler and she wanted to be with him. But she also, a lot of people don't know, that decision was a lot to do with me as well. Because Shaylee wanted to help me because she knew how passionate I was about getting Rosanna out of here. Now, where do me and Rosanna stand today? I love Rosanna. I think she's cool. Obviously, on the show, everything was real. You know, I was being miscommunicated information. Everybody told me she wanted me, you know, out of the show. And during that time being, if you want me out, I'm getting you out. And, you know, I did what I had to do. Obviously, the situation with Tyler and Shaylee helped tremendously. But also, Shaylee, again, was going to go home and send herself home. So I made sure that Tyler and Shaylee worked because I wanted Rosanna out of here. So I had a lot to do with that. The other reason why me and Rosanna had some sort of little problems prior to my conversation with her about wanting to do this competition together was the fact that she told me that I was not allowed to talk to Tyler. I was in a hot tub. This is a scene that you guys didn't see. And I was like, yo, I'm letting all you girls know I respect everything that's going on. If you're with your mans, I get it, but I want you to know in advance that I am here to make a connection. So with that being said, I will be having a one-on-one with every single boy here because I have to. And if you don't understand that, then I'm sorry. And the only person that had a problem with that was Rosanna. She said, you could talk to anyone, but it's not gonna be Tyler. I said, really? Watch. And guess what? The second she like turned her back, I said, hey Tyler, I actually might have even done it in front of her, I forget. You wanna take a walk? Tyler said, yeah, let's go. Really? I knew right there and then that if she was acting like that and Tyler was so quick to hop on me having a conversation with him, something was off with that connection. So I spoke to him. You're not gonna tell me that I can't talk to somebody, sorry. So that right there, I was like, she's gotta go. You know, that was my first impression. You know, the next morning she apologized and I respected that. You know, we were at the breakfast table. And she was like, yeah, Caitlin, look, I'm really sorry. Like, I shouldn't have acted like that. I was drunk. And I was like, look, it's all good. I appreciate you saying I'm sorry, but I'm just letting you know that I see where your connection stands. Because drunk or not, when you're like really secure with somebody, you don't act like that. I don't care what you say. A lot of people are asking like, where do you stand with these people? Me and Rosanna are great. I love her. I really do. I appreciate her existence. And I'm happy that we were able to drop whatever beef was happening. A lot of people are asking about me and Tyler. I wanna make this clear. When I walked into Paradise Hotel, the person that I had my eyes on, the person that I wanted to be with, the person that I wanted to do the show with was Tyler. He's my type. He was, you know, the first person I looked at, I was like, I need to know who he is. Fun fact about me and Tyler, we were actually on the same plane flying to Mexico to film. Like, we recognized each other. We had a lot of conversations on the show. I want to be honest with Tyler. I want to be real with him. I said to him, I go, look, I want you to know, you know, this was even before I knew about Shaylee. You're the person that I really want to do the show with, to be honest. You're the person that I want to win this competition with. And he told me, he was like, you know, if you walked in here first, you would have been the person that I would have wanted to do this show with too. So we both had the same agreement that we had the same interest. Every time we talked, we had a spot that we talked at. We wouldn't talk anywhere else. He'd be like, oh, you want to talk? We got to go to our couch. We talked a lot. We both agreed and both admitted that we do have feelings for each other. However, with circumstances, I'm completely respected that he's, you know, in his world and I'm in my own world and just things happened and it wasn't meant to be. I also want to make this very clear. Everything that I'm talking about, Shaylee knows about. She was there for a majority of everything. I was very honest with her. I told her, you know, before I knew you, I wanted to be with Tyler. He was the first person I had my eyes on. Super real, always honest. You know, I let people know how I feel at all times. There's no reason to hide it. The day that Tyler stood behind Brittany was a lot more to it than what it was. Tyler actually really wanted to be my partner. However, obviously you guys know I was with Carlos, but I had the choice to leave Carlos for Tyler. Why did I not do it? Because I felt like Carlos, the reason why I was even making it that far was because of Carlos. I asked Tyler, I said, Tyler, can you explain to me? Because honestly, guys, I really was torn. I was like, maybe I should do the rest of this competition with Tyler rather than Carlos. Maybe I knew things were kind of going on with Carlos. He was being a little skeptical, but I was like, maybe I should let Carlos go. So I asked Tyler, I said, Tyler, can you explain to me why I should pick you? Like, where did you show that you cared? And he said, Caitlin, number one, I stood there and talked to you that day that Rosanna was freaking out. I cared a lot to get to know you. You guys are really hearing the tea right now, let me tell you. And the reason why Tyler, after a whole day of trying to decide what I wanted to do, stood behind Brittany was because I told him, look, before the ceremony starts, I will make sure to let you know if I'm going to pick Carlos or you, because I'm not gonna let you go home. And right before the ceremony started, I looked at him and I said, no, stand behind Brittany because I'm going to stay with Carlos. And he looked at me and he was like, okay. And that's why he stood behind Brittany. Brittany was super supportive of what was going on between me and Tyler during that day. She told me, Caitlin, just let me know if you're going to pick Tyler or not, because if you don't, you know, I'll save Tyler as a friend. I want Tyler to stay. And I said, Brittany, thank you so much for being understanding. Like, she was totally okay with everything that was going on. And I really do love Brittany for constantly being super supportive. The only thing that I'm upset about to this day, I'll always be a little is obviously you guys know that I was there for Brittany. I said, Brittany, Tatum is plotting against you. Please listen to me. She didn't believe me. And, you know, even after watching the episodes and she saw I was telling the truth, she still, during the finale, stood behind Bobby and Tatum. And that made me really upset. So I was like, man, like, what? I was there for you. Like, I don't. And, you know, I get it. She's friends with Bobby. It is what it is. But I really thought that that meant something to her and she would have had my back. But no big deal. I still love her. I always respect her. And, you know, I'm looking forward to hanging out with her in LA. One of the most common questions, where do me and Carlos stand? Firstly, I want to say that I think that everybody forgot something big, the bigger picture of Paradise Hotel. We only known each other for what, 2-3 weeks? If you get with another girl behind my back at Paradise Hotel, you're not cheating on me, okay? I was with you for a week. When Carlos did kiss Tatum, I told him, look, I don't like you like that. We're roommates, we got each other's back. I care so much about you that I will make sure you win this show with me, if anything. But I don't have a romantic connection with you. So if you need to go and do what you want to do and find that at Paradise Hotel, the door's open. So he was allowed, this is something people don't know, he was allowed to kiss Tatum. I was not, in the moment when it happened, I was not mad. I was just mad that he lied and didn't tell me about it. I told him, go. If there's someone else here that you really like romantically, as long as your loyalty stays with me, and you don't choose or change roommates, you can do whatever you want. When I found out though, at the end, that he kissed Tatum first, I actually got a little jealous. And that was when I was like, hey Carlos, that kind of bothered me. Maybe I do like you a little bit. By the end of the show, when it was the finale and you know, whatever, I actually did like Carlos. Where do me and Carlos stand now? We are just friends. He lives in Naples, Florida. I live in Brooklyn, New York. Completely two different spots. And to be honest, at the age of 21, I'm not looking to do long distance. It's unnecessary. I'm busy. I'm grinding. I have a lot going on. I don't need that extra, if you will, headache. I don't need to do long distance. But I'm super thankful that he's in my life. He's my friend. He sent me workout plans. I appreciate you, Carlos. But as of right now, that's not where I want to be. The reason why people were crying when Kendall and David left was because Jair, love you Jair, but he did not let them speak to say their last final goodbyes. And we felt shitty because we already booted them off. And now Jair won't even let them say their last goodbyes because his ass was drunk and he had to pee. Like, we were like freaking out. I want to make this very clear. Jair is probably one of my favorite boys on the show. Bobby Ray and I are not together. Me and Marilena are friends. You know, during that situation, I kind of just stood out of it. It really wasn't my place to speak. You know, they were there before me at Paradise Hotel. So whatever it is that they need to solve, they can solve without me. Would you have dropped the ball on Carlos? Yes. Yeah. $250,000, I would have slammed that ball down. Carlos treated me amazing, straight up. Like, he would cut my steak for me, open the door for me, always a gentleman, always there for me, ask if I'm okay, giving me a hug if I was stressed out. He was there for me when everybody wanted me off Paradise Hotel. I have complete respect for Carlos, no matter what anybody says. He's a great person, and I'm happy that I did this show with him. Lastly, Hans with the finale, that was probably one of the hardest things that I went through on the show. I know it was something very little, but for me, I really thought that I won for a second. I was winning, he was walking my way. And for him to do that during a really vulnerable moment for me, it was like really hard. I don't think he realizes how much it affected me because he wasn't sitting in my seat, but it wasn't cool. Tatum really sucked during this whole show. There were many times where Tatum was like, Caitlin, I don't want to do this with you anymore. You know, please. I feel like I'm glowing right now. I don't want this with you. Like, you're strong. Like, let's do this together. And then she went behind my back and did something else. Like, Tatum, like, let me know when you're done. Oh, you're not done yet? Okay, keep going. You know, I never was like, oh, I feel 100% with Tatum. Like, she was just always off the shit. And I'm like, is this girl okay? But you know what? Again, it's a competition. Okay, and when there's $250,000 at risk, respect. I just want to say thank you to everybody who listened to my YouTube video, watched the whole thing, got the tea, got the inside scoop, got my answers to certain things. Your DMs to me about being the realest person means the world to me because that was my ultimate goal. I wanted to go on this show and show that you can go on a show like this and win being real. Straight up. Thank you everybody who left in my DMs about being the realest person because it really does mean the absolute world to me. Thank you to everybody that watched. Just subscribe and I'll talk to you guys soon.